Sound is the only way for us to communicate in an effective manner. But can we travel at the speed of sound? And what will happen to your body if you travel so fast? We are speculating about what if we travel at the speed of sound in today's video of DiscoverZen. In physics, sound is defined as a vibration that propagates as a wave through a transmission medium such as solid, liquid, or gas. This means that, in space, you can't produce sound because space is a vacuum. In human physiology, sound is the reception of waves and their perception by the brain. Only acoustic waves that have frequencies lying between about 20 Hz and 20 kHz are audible to humans. The speed of sound also changes between mediums. It's around 343 meters per second in dry air at 20 degrees Celsius or 68 degrees Fahrenheit. Now let's look at something faster than the speed of sound. Fighter jets are the most common ones when it comes to traveling more than the speed of sound. The fastest one is the North American X-15, which can travel with a top speed of 7,274 kilometers per hour, or about 4,520 miles per hour. That is around 6 times the speed of sound. It's also reported that its speed can reach up to Mach 6.7 at around 100 kilometers above the surface. A Mach number is a ratio of an object's speed in a given medium to the speed of sound in that medium. Mach 1 is the speed of sound, around 761 miles per hour at sea level. The X-15 travels at hypersonic speeds. If something moves with less than Mach 1 or speed less than sound, it's called subsonic speeds. For Mach equals to 1, it's called transonic. Similarly, speeds greater than Mach 1 is called supersonic, and greater than Mach 5 is called hypersonic speeds. But even when a jet travels more than the speed of sound, the pilot inside will just feel normal. The only problem for them can be a quick acceleration. But outside the flight, it creates something called a sonic boom. This boom is extremely loud, and it can even shatter some glass. So, has any person traveled at the speed of sound? And the answer is, yes, of course, but not by running. Austrian Felix Baumgartner became the first skydiver to move faster than the speed of sound, reaching a maximum velocity of 833.9 miles per hour, or 1,342 kilometers per hour in the year 2012. Well, how did he do that? He jumped out of a balloon 24 miles or 39 kilometers above the Earth's surface over New Mexico. He did land safely because of his special suit, but if there was one crack in the suit, he would have died instantly. Now, what would happen if you wanted to run with the speed of sound? It's literally impossible as we are limited by our body strength. The reason why we could never run away close to 760 miles per hour is because human muscles don't contract that fast. In fact, the reason why we can't run very fast at all is because the speed at which our muscle fibers contract is relatively slow. So now we know that the human body can't really reach any speeds close to the speed of sound. Now let's imagine another scenario. What if we could travel at the speed of light? Well, that sounds like a different topic to speculate and investigate on DiscoverZen.